Before we air, we would like to bring awareness to the recent typhoon in the Philippines. Over 10,000 people died and over 600,000 people were injured. This upcoming week, we will be collecting donations and works to providing the resources that they are now lacking. Updates show that they're getting more and more desperate by the minute. Donations need to be fast so they can be sent out immediately. Let's work to give back to those who are suffering. We as a school can make a difference.
What up, West Hampton Beach? I'm TP, and with me is my co-anchor, Emma G. We have a packed show for me today, so it should be a good one.
First up today, yours truly got the inside scoop at the Senior Skills Breakfast on November 1st.
Good morning, West Hampton Beach. I'm here at the annual Senior Skills Breakfast at the West Hampton Beach Country Club. Behind me are some of West Hampton Beach's seniors meeting with mentors in their desired job field. Let's take a look.
What are you here for?
I'd love to be involved in communications and public relations and maybe go into something with social media managing.
If you know what you do and you love what you're going to do, follow your dreams. Getting out of bed and loving what you do every day is the biggest thing, best blessing you could possibly ask for. So know what you want to do and go for it.
I'm interested in being a physician assistant, and I found that this is a great opportunity to make connections and learn about my future field.
Make a name for yourself. Talk to as many people as you can and get them to remember you. Not only talk to people, but connect with them. Ask questions. Make sure that your goals are known.
Hey Emma, what do you think of my beard? Coming in thick, huh?
Sure, whatever you say, Tyler. Here's Izzy and Reid with a quick Brovember update. Now time for a classic.
That's right, Wheel of Fortune.
Not quite. Let's see how some of our fellow students stood against West Hampton's fifth graders in Connor, Dana, and Carly's version of Are You Smarter Than a Fifth Grader?
Are you smarter than a
fifth grader?
Who is considered the founding father of our Constitution?
Obama?
Thomas Jefferson.
What is the tallest peak in the United States?
I know the tallest peak is Mount McKinley.
In what city was the first president inaugurated?
How am I supposed to know that?
What is the name for the side of the moon we don't see?
Isn't it on the other side of the world?
There's a side we don't see.
The dark side.
The dark side.
Which document laid out the original plan for the U.S. government in 1781? How many branches of government were there under the Articles of Confederation?
Two.
And I really don't know.
There was one branch of government.
Well, that just about wraps it up for today, Hurricanes. Don't forget to like all my selfies on Facebook.
I think what you meant to say was to check our website and like our Twitter and Instagram pages.
Ooh, I meant what I said. Anyway, thanks for watching, West Hampton.
And thanks for letting us watch the whole entire show, Mr. Lacker.
Stay frosty out there. And now we leave you with some of the nicknames of our fellow students.
What's your nickname?
Big Mike.
Why do they call you Big Mike?
Ever since the 10th grade, when I started having a size 14 shoe, they started calling me Big Mike, so I just grew into the nickname, I guess.
My nickname in college was Fat Guard, with a P-H-A-T, not F-A-T.
Why do they call you a Fat Guard, with a P-H?
Because of my abilities on the basketball court at the University of Bridgeport.
They call me Cinderblock.
What are your nicknames?
Mr. Burkout has coined the nickname D-Block.
And sorry to say, Ms. Phillips came up with Flo Rida.
People call me a bunch of different things. I have Steve, Tags, Stevie Wonder, Stevie Nelson, and Stevie Johnson.
Do you have a nickname?
Big Daddy.